Oh, listen to Mike McCready.
The McCreeds.
And I'm very good friends with the Pearl Jams. I'm very, very good friends with the Pearl Jams. But, I mean, honestly, like Green Day, hadn't really ever listened to their music until this whole change here on 108.9 The Hawk. And I got to say, I like the Pearl Jams.
Out of all of the new classic rock.
Out of all
I gotta
the new
say, they're the closest
rock.
To the old classic rock.
Oh, yeah.
Than the most of the new classic rock.
They've got a song called Yellow Ledbetter.
Oh, my
that
God.
That we play three times an hour on the hour.
And it replaced the Doobies, listen to the music, as our most played song.
R.I.P. Doobie Brothers.
Rest in power.
Rest in power.
They're still playing. They're on tour right now.
They're still alive.
You're not going to hear them on this goddamn station.
Right. Skunk Baxter is still alive and making all kinds of rockets. And I think he's really working on weapons to fight the aliens when disclosure happens, Geoff.
I mean, if we're not going to listen to Skunk, who are we going to listen to?
If you put it on a shirt.
Put that on a shirt.
I'll wear that on a goddamn shirt. If you're
I'll
not
going to
listen to Skunk Baxter, who are you going to listen to?
I'm not going to listen to Billy Corgan, I'll tell you that much. I might not even listen to Dan Aykroyd.
Wait, Billy, are you in here?
Oh my God, was that Billy Corgan? I don't see any scarves or weird, ill-fitting hats, so I don't know if that was him.
Dude loves Disney.
Dude loves Disney. That's one of my favorite Smashing Pumpkins covers of an Aerosmith song.
Oh, yeah.
Dude loves Disney. Surprisingly less problematic than the original song.
That's what a lot of people are saying about the Geoff and Whisp Show on 108.9 The Hawk. My God, 6:03. Good morning, everybody.
And I can't believe it's 6:03 and we've played Yellow Ledbetter and another Pearl Jam song already four times.
That's math, kids. If you're going to school and you're learning, you can learn how to do math here on the Geoff and Whisp Show. Speaking of the Geoff and Whisps,
all that Yellow Ledbetter going straight to the brain. You know what I'm saying?
Every time Yellow Ledbetter comes on, I'm like, this is my favorite Jimi Hendrix song.
Oh my God, it's my favorite.
Oh, Jimmy, give it to me.
Come on now, Cinnabon.
Now, is Eddie Vedder singing about Cinnabons in that
he
song?
He is.
Cinnabons. And then don't taste sweet.
The Yellow Ledbetter is what his poo looks like when he eats all those Cinnabons. That's what I think it's about, I'm just saying. we have fun here at 6:04 in the AM.
6:04, God almighty, that happened.
Already making poop jokes.
We're already making poop jokes. And, you know, that's what happens on morning radio. You love it, you got it, you want some more of it. And here's something I could do a little less of. Val Verde Rag. Vanessa Creve hit the old Whisp Turlington again with this morning's paper. I hate Vanessa Creve. I hate the Val Verde Rag, the old gray lady.
The old gray lady. Now the old gray lady sends text notifications.
Oh, yeah, I get them.
And I got one this morning. It just said, I don't even know. It was behind the paywall. That's the thing. The paywall for the Val Verde Rag is so expensive. One half of an article every month. And mine, all it said was, Whisp sucks. and then I tried to go, how does he suck this time, Vanessa? Yeah. But the paywall, it hit me. It came down like that wall in Die Hard. That electromagnetic wall that can only be solved by the FBI. You know what I'm talking about.
Yep, you got to get in there. You got to start.
Get in there.
You got to start moving that DOS program around can get in and open the vault.
It's so good that they brought in a computer guy to work that DOS program.
Oh, you got
to
bring in a computer
guy. He's in there trying to play King's Quest over there. Yeah, maybe a game of Zork in between.
Like, guys, I would like to play Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy game over here. But
stop playing Leisure Suit Larry.
Whoa.
Was Alan Rickman's ghost in here? Oh my God.
That's a new one. We only usually get Greg Allman's ghost, but Alan Rickman's
ghost. Hey, man, I ain't no angel. Oh, well, we do have Greg Allman's ghost in here.
Perfect. But I do want to say this. Vanessa Creve, she hit me again, man. She reviewed the Geoff and Whisp Show, formerly known as the Whisp Turlington Show, known as the Geoff and Whisp Show.
Well, you don't have to say it in that tone. I mean, come on.
She said,
we have the Minions in here now.
Yeah. Whoa, is that a Minion? Said it is a breath of fresh air since Geoff moved up to the top spot over that murderer. Sounds like something still has, someone hasn't gotten over the fact that I killed her writing partner, Steve Lust. And Vanessa, you gotta let it go.
I mean, the statute of limitations on grief is like a week, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, thank you for talking about the show.
All press is good press, especially when the good press is for me, mostly not for you as much, but that's fine. It's mostly because of the murder.
Another thing I got to bring up with you really quickly, Geoff, I ate at Blue Tuna yesterday. My God, I went out to Blue Tuna, and you know what? I got the sirloin and the Blue Tuna shrimp special. And usually when I get that, I get a hunk of meat and at least 20 to 30 shrimps.
Of course.
And they've been in the news lately. They've been on the Val Verde rag because they lost their ass on their shrimp till you puke promotion. Okay, now is that my fault? Is it
fault? It's in the title, shrimp till you puke. So you're going to shrimp it until you puke it. And that's going to be a lot of shrimp.
So it seems like they're lessening all of the shrimps that we get now in their regular dishes in Blue Tuna. I'm coming for you all morning long. All morning long, I'm talking nothing but shit about Blue Tuna. I want that place to sink into the ground.
And I just got to say,
Poseidon,
by the way,
Poseidon to come out and pull them back.
I just got to say, and can I get an I just got to say?
Is this a I got to say? Hold on. Okay, here we go.
Look, I just got to say, Blue Tuna, I know you were trying to get around that shrimp till you puke deal by giving us those hard cheddar scones nonstop.
Ugh.
But I tell you, you keep giving me 20 baskets, I'm going to eat 20 baskets, and I'm not going to feel bad about it. So you can tell those waiters to stop giving me that side eye, keep bringing the hard cheddar scones, and keep letting my friend Whisp puke shrimp. Thank you. I just had to say that.
Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. You know what else I appreciate? 6:05.
1 minute.
1 minute just passed. 6:05.
Some things change on the show, but the strange passage of time does not. We really got to get scientists looking at that one.
Ever understand it. We'll never understand it. But one thing I do understand, it's a new thing that we're doing right here on the Geoff and Whisp Show. And we like to call it Local Celebrity Spotlight. It's where we take people in Val Verde and we make the stars in Val Verde. Now, these people may already be stars in their own minds, Geoff, and they may be stars to our community, but they're not
officially stamped. They may be delusional.
No, they have not been.
They might be in their brains, just like, I'm a star. It's like, there's nothing going on.
I am the star. It's just,
until we give you that hawk stamp right on your forehead.
Choo-choo.
Bagong.
Bagong. That's how it works. But we make the stars. And of course, this is one of the biggest stars out there, just making a name for themselves. Now, of course, everybody knows the Val Verde High School mascot is the Hard Lesson.
Oh, my God.
And the Val
Verde. One of the best in the biz.
High School Hard Lesson football team. I really think they're going to do it this year. I really think they're going to do it this year. And I say that every year.
Every year. And every year, the record is -24. And I don't even understand how they're getting a negative.
I don't get it.
That's the hard lesson that Hard Lesson's teaching you.
But they've got a cheer squad that just keeps cheering them on, led by the wonderful Crystal Parker. Welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
Oh, my God. It is so exciting to have Crystal Parker, Val Verde High School cheer coach, captain. What is your official title there?
I'm the cheer coach, but I just want to clarify that I'm the coach for the cheer squad, not for the football team.
Oh,
because because of budget cuts, we didn't have suitable uniforms to wear outdoors this season. So my cheer squad is strictly indoors. We cheer for lunch.
You cheer for lunch.
For lunch.
That's it.
Yeah. Just for cheering the kids on as they're getting lunch, cheering on the lunch ladies as they're dishing out the lunch because they need support too. And so not football. I mean, maybe one day, knock wood, if we play our cards right, we'll be back out there on the football field.
I'm knocking right here for you. I'm knocking big time. No, that's no one. I'm knocking wood with.
Oh, God.
Someone was at the door. I'm not going to whip.
Jesus. Every time he does that, he gets me. I'm just like, whoa, who?
Freddie can throw. Yeah, Freddie can throw.
But for now, you can see us out at lunch on the odd days of the week: Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Oh, not
so. If I'm going, so, yeah,
Tuesday, Thursday,
we are training days for us, so we take it off. But Monday,
no
Wednesday,
no school for you on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
No, because train. You know the kid. It's like it's a heavy mental load where sure. you know we're. In a supportive role. Yeah. And so the kids take a mental health day on Tuesdays and Thursdays because some say education first. I say mental health first. So I like to give the kids Tuesdays and Thursdays off of school entirely.
If only now, that was the Whitney Houston Whitney Houston. Better singer than Whitney Houston.
Much better than Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston is a hack. Yeah.
Whitney Houston. So good. I believe mental health is our future.
Yes. Teach it well
and let it show the way. There you go. Makes you think.
It makes you think. Yeah, I was thinking of choreographing a dance routine to that song. It's a little slow.
Yeah, it's so slow.
Oh my god.
Yeah, but
you think it's one of those YouTube videos where they've slowed it down like 200%, and then nope, that's just the Houston touch right there.
Like that one Tracy Ullman song that they slowed down, and when they slowed it down, it sounded like Tears for Fears. Have you heard that song? It really freaks me out every time.
The Tracy Ullman song, the comedian,
one of my favorite recording artists.
I love Tracy Ullman. So yes.
Honestly, Tracy Ullman did have a career.
Honestly, before Tracy the comedy. Ullman. That was what she went by. Oh, honestly, Tracy Ullman.
She's a comedian. Yeah, you just know her from her music because that's what you guys cheer to.
Yeah, I just know the music because obviously, like, I'm into movement and and the choreography. I didn't know she's a comedian. I have to check that out.
Is actually, honestly, a comedian. Yeah, it is so good. It is so grand, and you guys dance to her music so well.
Oh, thank you. Thanks. Yeah, we have a big competition coming up, so that's why I wanted to come on the Hawk this morning real early before I got ready for school and just sort of like raise awareness about cheerleading and like what it is in case you never heard of it. I think
that's a good one. That's a good one. What is it?
What is cheerleading?
What is
maybe
cheerleading,
I don't know. What is it exactly?
It's a good
there's
question,
a lot of
actually.
Idiots. There's a lot of idiots listening to this radio show and they need to know just as much as we do.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what it is myself or like why we do it. I feel like it kind of gets a bad reputation from like that mean coach on that show Glee. And then that mean coach that was on that show Cheer that like let the cheerleaders do crimes.
Cheers.
Right. Cheers.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Carla Tortelli is very mean. Very
so
mean.
Cheers.
Cheers. Yeah, I don't think that had to do with cheerleading, but I'm not really...
Younger. We're trying to teach you some lessons here, and you've been missing Tuesdays and Thursdays, so maybe you didn't pick up that Cheers was mostly about cheerleading, Coach.
Okay, I will have to check that out after I check out Tracy Ullman's comedy.
Yes.
I don't really have a background in cheerleading, so I don't know a lot about it. For example, when you said the mascot for Val Verde High, I hadn't even looked into that yet.
You didn't know that you guys were the hard lessons.
No, and I'm so happy that I know that now because I think that will be some good information to have when we're making
some
cheers and we'll know what we're cheering for. But I don't really have a cheerleading background. I'm doing it as like community service hours.
What is your background, Crystal?
Well, my background is, I'll just tell you a little bit about myself that I'm allowed to talk about is, I have to do the cheerleading for community service hours because are you familiar with super couponing?
Oh my God. Am I familiar?
Extreme couponing.
Franny.
Yeah. So
Franny, the British woman that runs everything at Turlington Manor, is a coupon freak. And I say, Franny, I go in there and it's just piles and piles. It's almost like a Scrooge McDuck situation, but instead of coins, it's nothing but coupons. And
I've never seen this amount of OxyClean and vitamin water in Turlington Manor.
What am I going to do with all this OxyClean? I say
so
that
much
every time. And then I look
for
the camera.
Where's the camera? She's keeping you prepared. Yeah. So anyway, I was accused of counterfeiting coupons, but that's not true.
I actually stole
Bed Bath & Beyond coupons from the mailboxes of everyone on my street.
That doesn't sound too illegal.
No, that's fine.
Yeah, I mean, I just figured people put them in their car. They keep them in there. They're not using them, right?
They're not
so I
using
was
it.
I had planned to sell them from a website or like develop an app. I was trying to develop an app. Anyway, cut to
long story long.
Long story long, there was a scandal. I got in a little bit of hot water because of it. Ironically, Bed Bath & Beyond is out of business. So
what are you going to do with those now? That was my question here on the...
I sort of feel like I should be let off the hook. It's like now really that weed,
is there a
weed
statute
is legal in a lot of places. Like people should get out of jail for weed. I feel like Bed Bath & Beyond doesn't exist anymore. You can let me off the hook for a minor indiscretion for coupons that are now useless. But anyway...
You need to write our senator, Senator D. Snyder,
of course,
and ask Senator Snyder, is there any way we can just wipe this slate clean?
I feel like he'll understand because...
Oh, you think that, but here's the thing D. Snyder. You look at D and you're like, this guy can... Of course, everybody listening, D. Snyder from Twisted Sister, you look at this guy and you're
and
like,
the
this
movie
guy...
And the movie Strangeland that we mostly know him from.
Everybody knows him from that wonderful piece of cinema history. But you look at D. Snyder and you're like, this guy's cool. This guy is going to understand it, but then he's just a fucking like straight-laced dork. He's like, you should be in jail for weed. I'm gonna hog tie you in jail.
And he'll pull out that mini constitution he keeps in his back of his pocket. He's never read it, but he waves it at you.
He waves it at you and smacks
And he'll say, Bed Bath & Beyond, I don't care if it's bankrupt that you are. And then that's you don't even listen to what he's saying.
So
like,
maybe let's see.
He became more conservative in his old age, like all the greats. All the, like, Kid Rock and.
Oh, all the greats. Just list them up.
I mean, Kid Rock used to be the most liberal musician you could ever imagine.
Gary Sinise.
Gary Sinise.
There was never anyone so progressive as Gary Sinise. And now, God, what happened?
Kevin Sorbo might as well have been putting flowers in the guns.
I still have a Kevin Sorbo poster from back in the day.
Hercules Day. Of course.
Yeah, Hercules.
What pose was it? Is it the arms up? Or is it the on the belly? The hands doing like the diamond on the belly?
I think it's like hands on the hips, like a real power pose.
You should put that in plastic. What is that
Very
called,
sassy.
Geoff? What are people doing now with the collectibles? You were telling me about it before the show.
You got to slab it.
Slab it.
You should slab.
Crystal. You got to slab it.
We should get that professionally rated. Kevin Sorbo.
Let's take the real Kevin Sorbo.
Slab him.
And let's slab him, but it's one of the ones you can't take screws out of. Like, he's just in there.
He's in there.
Oh,
he's
my God.
And he might not be able to breathe, but you'll see him. And he ain't going to rot or anything.
Our producer behind the glass is nodding his head. He's getting Sorbo on the horn, so we're going to get him over here. Crystal, we got to get to a little business. Can you hang out with us and talk more about the Val Verde High School Hard Lessons Cheer Squad?
I would love to.
Oh, my God. Well, we are going to talk more about that. But first, we have to go to traffic.
108.9 The Hawk traffic with Art Spart.
Well, people of Val Verde, get ready for the amazing new reissue of Bruce Springsteen's The River. But this time, it is not a reissue of a classic double album. In fact, it's not even an album. It is an actual river. And it does not involve Springsteen. That was just old Art's cute way of saying, I need to apologize for the literal river that is coming out of Art Spart's house. And currently clogging up the Dave the Snake Sabo Circle and all of Saigon Kick Junction and causing quite the traffic jam. Look, it's my fault. I am having a bit of a plumbing problem at my house and it's a disaster for me and now the town of Val Verde. Now, according to my plumber, apparently you aren't supposed to really put food into your food disposal. What the hell are you supposed to do with this thing? My Mama Spart, always told me put everything in there, and especially eggshells to sharpen the blades. And I take my mama's words to heart. Now, lately, I've been enjoying quite a bit of Alexis Rock Rock's Rock Rock dinners. And when I say I enjoy them, I mean I keep messing them up. 1 second too long or too short, and that blueberry chicken is inedible. So I've been dumbing it down the incinerator. Well, long story short, that mashed up blueberry chicken mush has completely gummed up all of my pipes, all through my house and the sewers, and I had blueberry chicken coming out of my toilet. And to make matters worse, let me just say, do not mix Drano with blueberry chicken. It became some sort of sentient blueberry chicken beast that kind of resembles a chimera but with the tenacity of the Loch Ness Monster. But tastes sweeter! Don't worry, I killed it with my Monster Hunter skills, and then, oops, I put it down the incinerator! Some people never learn. Mostly me. Well, suffice it to say, shithole plumbers have used their magic snake powers, and everything should be clear in my house. But now, it is just all running down the streets of Val Verde. Oops! My bad! So maybe just wait for it to dry up in a little bit, and if you see any more sentient blueberry chicken, just give old Art a call! And that has been traffic from the Burt's Funeral Flowers traffic desk on 108.9 The Hawk. This is Art Spart.
With Burt's Funeral Flowers, with Burt's Funeral Flowers.
Okay, Art. Well, I guess don't drive around out there if you...
Glad he got a hold of shithole plumbers, though.
Well, shithole plumbers. Doing the job. Best plumbers in the business. I've had them coming out to Turlington Manor so many times. Oh, this sounds like classic rock. What is this? Nope, that's not classic rock, yeah. But it's Blind Melon on the Hawk. What we didn't want to happen has happened. Yes, the company lost its ass on the shrimp till you puke promotion. And now Blue Tuna is cutting back.
Cutting back.
But we're still Blue Tuna, Val Verde's favorite mall chain fish restaurant. So come in for all your favorites, like Admiral Dan's clams. Sure, you used to get 16 clams on every plate, but now the Admiral says you'll do with 5. Or maybe try our Big Fish Boy platter. That used to come with 3 pieces of fish, clam strips, fries, a salad, and a baked potato. Now it just comes with 1 piece of delicious, delicious fish. You're still a big boy, so eat it! Just because we're cutting back on portions, it doesn't mean we're not the Blue Tuna you've loved all these years. So please, 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 come on down to Blue Tuna. We could really use you here.
Are you a consensual adult looking for consensual sexual pleasures? Well then come on down to Val Verde's hottest swingers club, Sebastian's Playground. I'm the owner and proprietor, Danny Coscarelli, and I can promise you there is a lot of hot stuff going on down at Sebastian's Playground. Not to mention the hottest buffet at any swingers club in all of Val Verde. Now, of course, I can't get into details about what happens here at Sebastian's Playground. That would be legalities if I get in the way, but I can tell you a little bit about that buffet. They're going to be donuts and sausages and hot dogs. And you can maybe put one of those sausages into a donut, if you know what I mean, while you're munching on some hot apple pie. Now, these are all, of course, sexual euphemisms, but they're also actual items on the hot buffet we offer every night down here at Sebastian's Playground. So if you want to come and have some hot swigger sex, and that's all I can say about that. But if you also want to, like, double-team a kibasi or something, again, sexual euphemism, but also we've got kibasi if you want it there. So come on down to Sebastian's Playground. It's erotic. And a good buffet.
Oi, it's Mick Jagger. And even though the Hawk may have changed a little bit, it's still the same Hawk all night long.
Oh, now that's what I'm talking about. We put the faces on. That's the faces, right, Geoff?
That production made me think that was a new classic rock. What was that?
The Black Crowes.
Black Crowes.
Okay, well, I thought we were listening to old Rod Stewart and the Faces. Rod Stewart, one of my best friends in the entire world. Oh, I was just talking to him on the horn the other night. And you know what
was Rod talking about?
Rod was talking a lot. He's really big into, he reads Reddit all the time. And he's really big on all of the alien Reddits, like UFOs or high strangeness or aliens. And he's talking about disclosure. And he's like, Whisp, I think it's going to happen soon. And I'm like, Rod, I don't know. I just don't know. And he's like, Whisp, I'm one of them.
And you're like, I don't know.
And I'm like, I don't know. Because literally I was reading something else. I was just, when I talk to Rod, it's just bullshit, bullshit, bullshit. And I'm reading a book or something.
I would imagine that. You know, I listen to Faces. I listen to Solo Rod. I'm just like, in one ear, out the other, if this guy was talking to me. Just like, bleep, bleep.
Did he admit he's an alien?
I don't know.
Back, I record every single phone call.
Of course.
Scotty, can we play that phone call with me and Rod Stewart? Great. Here we go. Tina.
Oh, that's great, Rod.
And I'm also I'm an alien. I'm an actual alien, Whisp.
You ever,
are you listening? Are you listening?
No. The Faces thing, and the you did that.
No, I stopped talking about Faces 20 years ago with you.
Oh,
I've been explaining all of this. The secret societies of the Greys.
Trying to figure out when I'm gonna get a blue tuna.
Oh, you went to blue tuna.
Did you get the
shrimpy till you pukey did?
They're not running it right now, Ron.
Are you bloody bogging me? That's a bunch of boto.
That's a great, and see, he's pissed off about blue tuna too, Scotty, if you listen closely.
Even aliens are pissed off about this. If he's an alien, I started zoning out because, again, that's Rod Stewart. In one ear, out the other one. He's like,
I
heard you in the phone call.
Crystal, you're still hanging out with us. What did you think?
Did you hear Rod Stewart?
Did you hear Rod Stewart admit to being an alien?
I wasn't listening.
That'll do it.
That's a regular Rod Stewart conversation. All right, there. Oh, my God, it is the Geoff and Whisp Show, and we're talking all about our local celebrities because you got to celebrate them. And in our local celebrity spotlight today, of course, you know it, we are talking to the one and only Crystal Parker, Val Verde High School Hard Lessons cheer coach, talking about all the great stuff. Now, you guys have tried to do a reality show based on your specific brand of cheer coaching. How is it going?
It's not going great. We've had some
Hold on, I need to boo that. Thank you.
Yes, I appreciate it. I appreciate, because our role is to support, and so I appreciate the support from you guys, because cheerleaders never get any support from anyone else. Nobody gives a shit. Yeah, no one gives a shit. And we've been trying to get this reality show going. And apparently, like, producers, Hollywood gatekeepers, they feel like my methods are unorthodox and like wouldn't be suitable to put on television, which is, I find it offensive because, you know, my kids work hard and I work them hard and I'm not ashamed of it. And I think it's something to be proud of. So yeah, Hollywood gatekeepers, two thumbs down.
You know, yeah, I've never cared much for Hollywood gatekeepers, and I'll be the first to say it.
Who's your least favorite Hollywood gatekeeper, Geoff?
Oh, all right, who's my number one? Eric Estrada. I've tried my best to get on that celebrity weirdo Christmas parade that he hosts.
Yep.
That is just like one block, I think, on Sunset. And you can see where the parade begins and ends if they don't have those cameras right. And I say, I can see the angles. Why won't you let me on there? Eric Estrada just says, I don't know who you are. You're not from Hollywood.
It's a perfect example. Geoff, the Val Verde cheer squad has never been invited to be in that weirdo Hollywood parade. I've been in it three times.
I went down with Robert Pine, the sergeant from Chips.
Yeah,
okay. He's a very good best friend of mine. We got on a bike together, and he said, "You know what, Whisp? Why don't you wear the Chips helmet?" And I'm like, "Oh my God!"
And you were just on a 10 speed, and he's on a motorcycle.
And then he crashes.
Wow! And that helmet seems heavy. Did it throw off your balance on the 10 speed?
So heavy, so hard to ride a bike. Yeah. And honestly, Robert Pine could have used it because he crashed in the parade and got a head injury. And it's
Is that why he's thinking? Yeah, that's insane. You were still wearing the helmet when you were with the cast of Baywatch Nights.
Yes.
In the back of that replica of the Christine car, which made no sense. It was like, why are you in the 57
Chevy? It's because they're fighting monsters.
Because they're fighting monsters. Right. I never put two and two together because Stephen King and Christine have nothing to do with Baywatch Nights, but that's weirdo Hollywood parade.
That's just gatekeeping in Hollywood.
And then you were with the cast of Cheer as well.
Cheers.
Oh, it was with Cheers. So yeah, you
I
and Carla Giacelli.
Okay.
See, this is what I'm talking about, gatekeeping. It's like they'll let Cheer reality shows in there.
There are so many Cheer reality shows. Of course, we've got Cheer on Netflix. We've got, on Channel 8 Plus Max, we've got Show Us Your Cheer and Girls Gone Cheerin', which was probably my favorite one out of the entire entire batch. So there's plenty of room for another cheer show.
Yeah, I guess it's just because, like, I mean, I think most cheer coaches in 2024 are looking to make their programs more inclusive because of, you know, I guess the wokeness.
Here woke mind virus. I'm coughing from it.
You know where I'm coming from. I feel like I like to make it more cutthroat and more, you know, I'm checking the kids' teeth. I'm checking their haunches.
Wait.
Like thoroughbred dogs. Beep.
Yes, you're checking haunches?
Yeah. I need to make sure that their haunches are strong and steady because it's a physically demanding program. We're out there, we're doing stunts. We're trying to push the envelope with partner stunts. And so I need to make sure I can't have shaky haunches out there on the floor.
Understand. I mean, it's these gatekeeper Hollywood people will not let you in because you're gatekeeping these cheer people. And you know, and it's like they don't understand.
They were questioning a little bit whether some of the members of the squad were actually in high school if I hadn't brought in, you know, 8 or 9 year old ringers because they're very small and
easy to throw.
Very high. Because here's the thing, the kids throwing the kids,
right?
They're also kids, so they're fucking weak.
It's just kids throwing kids, and they're fucking weak.
I need smaller kids to be thrown by the kids who aren't fully physically developed yet. And so, do I sometimes have to like go scout at an elementary school and lure an 8 or 9 year old to be tossed? Yes, I do.
Doesn't sound like there's anything wrong with that.
You just said the most clearest explanation I've ever heard. And you did this with one student. Of course, Val Verde, a hard lesson star. Leslie Tablets. You got her at a very young age. You could start those haunches when they're young, and then you're going to get the best haunches when they're older. And Leslie has had a star career so far.
My favorite moment with Leslie is, you know how in sports, sometimes we talk about like shooting the lights out, like that moment where Babe Ruth swings and like, you know, the baseball. We actually threw Leslie Tablets so high that she was able to take her little fist and punch the lights out when she was up
my God.
In the ceiling of the cafeteria. And then, of course, it was pitch dark in there because there's no windows. And it did cause a little bit of an incident.
This was during lunch.
It was during lunch and all the kids panicked.
Like, and it wasn't Taco Tuesday because you're not there on Tuesday. No, so it must have been like Freaky Pizza Friday.
Salisbury Steak Wednesday. Now, I've heard about this, and Scotty, our producer, asked me to ask about this incident. So I'm so very happy that you brought it up. I heard that Leslie, when she was up in the rafters and she punched out a light, she actually caught a football that was thrown and threw it right at Principal Sometimes and broke his fucking nose.
I heard that too.
Wow.
And
everyone was just screaming out, she's like Bo Jackson meets Captain Marvel. And even Principal Sometimes was like, that's exactly what I get. I mean, said that through a bleeding nose.
And then they were everywhere. I mean, we didn't see it again because it was pitch black and there was a lot of screaming. And some people were screaming because they were so excited. It was such a moment. And then some people were screaming
because there was glass in their Salisbury steak.
And they wanted to get out and get to safety.
Sure.
Listen, it was a memorable moment, right? And Leslie went on to become a star. And also like minimal scarring on
tons on Principal Sometimes.
Oh my God, so much. Hand. He looks like Two-Face meets Jigsaw right now.
God.
But
Oh my God! Hey,
yeah, but I mean, look, hey, you look, hey, hey, look, hey, hey, look, look, you shouldn't have a football in the lunchroom.
What was
say
the?
There you
he
go.
He was laying Thank down you. On the job. He's the principal.
Thank you. He's like, principal, whatever, and I'm like, come on.
If the principal lets a football, if you hang a football on the wall at the beginning of lunch period,
yes,
you have to expect that football to be caught and thrown into your face. If you're an authority figure,
right? So by a little child that's thrown into a light that hits it and causes
again,
minimal.
She was 8 years old. She was 8 years old.
Blame an 8 year old.
She lacks judgment, and she made a game time call in the moment. She was up in the air punching out the light, and she just reacted quick hands.
What
and
a
so
game time call. What a game time.
Because I think it's a lunchtime game time.
Yes. That's what people don't know about cheerleaders. We're making game time. Well, not we. I never was a cheerleader. Again, right. I'm just doing this for community. And then I got more community service hours added on to my sentence. Sentence is the wrong word. But because we threw that little girl up into the lights. And so I was held responsible.
You were. Principal sometimes they tried to get manslaughter on it. And it was like, he's not dead.
You're not dead.
But he really went for manslaughter charges.
His dating life is dead now because of his face. But,
yeah. I mean, man's laughter.
Date him, Kegstand. Right, where the hell did you come from?
We heard that. Kegstand, our dirtbag sidekick in the corner there.
I love that guy.
That's great. Oh, I do have to say that the Whisp and Geoff show. Oh, I missed that up. How you feel about that?
Vanessa Screed is going to be very upset now.
She's going to write a whole.
I hate that girl, by the way. She was a Val Verde cheerleader.
Really?
And she thought that her shit did not stink. I graduated with her, and I have beef with
Vanessa.
And
she wrote that tell-all article about your couponing.
Yeah.
Vanessa.
She's had it out for me since we were 8 years old, and she was recruited to be a Val Verde cheerleader. Maybe I really hate drones. You, Vanessa Creve.
Maybe I activate the drones, Geoff. It's today at Activate the Drones.
You might. I mean, we'll have to see how this conversation goes.
But I do want to say that the Geoff and Whisp Show is brought to you by the fabulous Thunderbirds Shipping Company. We'll ship it. Wrap it up. We'll ship it. If you need anything shipped, of course, Val Verde's fabulous Thunderbirds Shipping Company will ship anything, but they will not wrap it. And they are sponsors of the Geoff and Whisp Show, but they're also sponsors of Get Ready. Oh, my God, Geoff.
Larfs and barfs.
Larfs and barfs.
Crystal, hang around. You're going to love this. You're going to do this with us. It's called Larfs and Barfs. We look at local news and world news. That's very fun. And, oh, my God, we've got some great stuff for you this morning here on the Geoff and Whisp Show, 108.9 The Hawk. A wombat has won the world's oldest title.
This is a larf already.
This is a larf already. Sure, it's definitely not a barf.
You say the word wombat.
Woo! A Japanese zoo resident has been crowned the oldest wombat at the grand age of 34, proving that marsupials know how to live life to the fullest. That was a good one, Scotty. Ayo! Kegstand, what do you think about that?
I'm a wombat, Kegstand! Okay, the hell does that even mean?
That was not a really good...
nothing. You're just saying bullshit.
You're just saying, I'm that.
My God.
God. Sometimes he's...
Watch that become a catchphrase everybody loves.
Yeah, he's like, I'm that!
Oh, man.
Well, a stingray has a surprise baby. A Christ-like birth, a North Carolina aquarium is buzzing after a lone female stingray has mysteriously given birth, sparking questions about how it happened, or maybe she has a secret admirer, or could be Jesus.
This doesn't surprise me. This has happened to a lot of the kids I've coached over.
Spontaneously, and I'm sure they're like, there was no guy.
Yeah. And you
believe them.
Who am I to say otherwise? You know, I mean, we're talking about whether aliens exist or not. Yeah. All I care is that they keep cheering.
Cheering through the pregnancy, that's all you care about.
And we don't make it any easier on them. I'm sure the aquarium didn't make it any easier on the stingray that was there to do a job.
Yes.
And, you know, like, sometimes I work those kids so hard through their pregnancy that like the baby will be born with abs.
Of course, then you just have
a new cheerleader on your hands, and it all works out.
Think how high we can throw that baby.
Already got haunches.
Yeah,
you're doing the haunches before they're even doing the breathing.
Exactly. If we start pushing the paperwork through to get those babies with abs,
that
right
was not
on
a larf or a barf. That's just beautiful, right?
Thank you. More to come with Crystal Parker, but first it's okay.
All right,
I know this song. This is the song with the rapping and the fish.
Oh, the rapping fish. Yeah, I love rapping
fish.
Rapping
fish on the hook. Happy birthday, Richie Blackmore, from your friends at 108.9. The Hawk.
Are you in a band that's trying to make it to the next level? And are you also in a band that's realizing that the 90s are back? Well then come with me and I'll help you out down here at the Promo Hut. Hi, I'm Lance McStance, owner and proprietor of the Promo Hut, Val Verde's premier album promotion and artwork kiosk. That's right, we're that little weird kiosk located down at the Val Verde Mall in between the Auntie Anne's Pretzels that's never open, and the Orange Julius has been closed forever. The 90s are back in the worst way ever, and we here at the Promo Hut can make the world look at you and say, hey, you clearly didn't grow up in the 90s, but you love all the terrible aspects of it. You need some new band photos, and we can get you those, where everyone's wearing overalls, ringer tees, and dusters. And don't worry, we have a wide selection of hats for you to wear. From Kangols to Guardian Angel style hats to bucket hats. We have you covered for awkwardness. We can also provide you with the best artwork for your new album that you're going to release on tape for some reason. All of our artwork is made on an old Mac computer. We can easily make your album cover look like a third-tier nu metal record that had questionable aesthetics even then. And if you need a video, we've got you covered with all the fisheye lenses and video toaster effects that you might need. So come on down to the Promo Hut, where Lance McStance will make you look like the band that ends up in the cutout bin.
Hey little sister, you getting hitched? Hey little sister, our wedding is much too rich. Hey little sister, I've got a place for you. Hey little sister, a perfect wedding venue. Hey little sister, bounce house. It's a nice day to bounce again. It's a nice day for a bounce wedding. It's a nice day to bounce again.
Hello, it's Billy Idol, and yeah, every day is a good day for a bounce wedding. In 1991, after the success of my Cradle of Love video, I bought a surplus of 80 bounce houses, thinking the bounce house craze would be my next thing. Little did I know, it wasn't, so I quickly had to figure out what to do with 80 bounce houses. One day I'm driving down Sunset Boulevard, and I think to myself, bounce weddings. Who wouldn't want to be married in a bounce house, right? So Billy Idol's bounce weddings were born. And now you and your loved one can get married in a very early 90s bounce castle. Billy Idol's bounce weddings. 452 Aug Street, Val Verde.
Bounce again!
Paul McCartney and Wings. What, Scotty? That was Guns N' Roses.
Excuse me, baking powder. What are we doing here?
Really? They cover songs? You're saying they put cover songs on their records.
You're telling me that the spaghetti incident, question mark,
that
was
wasn't
not
all original songs.
I just assumed they would just change up their thing. It was like a precursor to Chinese democracy, but all right.
I have to retract a congratulations message that I sent to Axl Rose back in 1994 saying, I love all the original songs on the spaghetti incident.
You know what? As punishment, Scotty, take the general off the playlist.
Yeah, we're going to take...
We're not playing that new Guns N' Roses song.
Please
and
stop
even
asking.
If it sounds like Portishead, we're not going to do it. We just can't do it anymore.
Please stop calling the station asking us to play the new song from Guns N' Roses, The General.
The phones have been ringing off the hook. If there's one Guns N' Roses song we want to hear, yeah, it's the newest Guns N' Roses song.
Here we go. Line two, you are on.
The General! You gotta give me the General!
And click.
Jesus Christ.
And he's off. See? Okay.
See what we're having to deal with
what
here.
We're dealing with, Crystal.
It's terrible.
Everybody wants either the General or the new Pearl Jam song. And we are new classic rock, something that we are even having a hell of a time adjusting to here on the Geoff and Whisp Show.
Sure. It's like the New Testament a little, I feel like. Like a whole new
the
Bible?
Band Testament? Do they have a new album out?
Oh,
are we going to have to play a new song by
Do
the
we
band
have a new
Testament?
Album
now we're playing
Testament.
Maybe leave that for Robbie Agatocles Dalton Show, like Hellhole, because we're not going to be start playing thrash metal on here, too.
Not,
I mean, my head's going to explode.
Not yet.
Not yet. But if these Canadian broadcasters have anything to do,
well, we don't have them anymore, man.
We don't have them anymore.
No. Where have you been? That's the reason we're here.
I'm so lost.
They sold us back.
I heard that. I got a text last night that they bought us again. Wait. And then they sold it again.
Oh, see, wow.
See, I'm getting the back and forth here. I get
You're
these,
really
you know,
the back and forth. I should sign up for these notifications.
I tell you.
I will not do it. I will not do notifications unless I see one that says, Vanessa Creve from the Val Verde Rag has just been hit by a car driven by Crystal Parker. Could I see that notification in the future?
Oh, you know what? I think I can make that happen.
Oh my God, I don't even have to activate the drones. I don't even. Here's the thing. If you make that happen, Crystal, and this could be, this is what is premeditated. The police could look at this. Chief Pizzola of the Val Verde Police Department could look at this as premeditation, but we're just going to say we're talking rock.
And then he'll be like, that's fine. We're just
talking
rock.
That's a
talking
rock defense. And what I will say to you, Crystal, is if you hit Vanessa Creve with your car this afternoon, I will fund Tuesdays and Thursdays.
What? Wow. I do know where she hangs out. I have seen her hanging outside of Sir Max.
Sir Mac and Cheese, Paul McCartney's Mac and Cheese Bistro here in Val Verde.
She's always trying to meet Paul McCartney. She thinks that she can, like...
What an idiot.
Paul's always at Wings. He's never
he's
at
over
Sir
at Wings
Mac
Wings.
Cheese.
He's never at Sir Mac and Cheese.
Right. So I know where she... The only issue is I don't have a car, so I would need to borrow one of your cars.
Oh, Geoff can...
You can't, but I mean, I need to.
Why don't you? It's Geo.
My wife took the car.
Oh.
Somehow, even though we've been divorced for 10 years, she got the lawyers to get back in the mix.
Okay.
She's just taking stuff again.
Okay.
And I just said, all right, I can't afford it. Just take it away.
Plus, I worry that a Geo might not do the job. Does this station maybe have like a pickup truck or something? That
we have
around?
A biodiesel pickup truck.
We do have the God's Country. It's our country, God's Law Country.
And it's
our
biodiesel. Station. In my experience, it needs to have a little pickup in order to get the job
get
done.
Enough French fries.
It's good.
Oil in there.
No, it smells like McDonald's.
Yeah,
or Burger Tools. And,
that sounds great.
I mean, she'll smell you coming, but she might just be excited that she thinks Al Borland's coming her way.
And you know who else loves French fries? Paul McCartney. So maybe she's like, oh my God, is Sir Paul coming over here?
Right,
he's
and then
like,
I'll get to see the look on her face. We're just talking rock.
This is a legal defense. You get best of the biz lawyers. They're going to give you the "we're just talking rock" defense.
I will pay.
Chief Pizzola is going to say, "Look, they're just talking rock. I'm not going to put too much work into this." Everyone gets it in Val Verde.
I have best in the business lawyers on retainer for literally anything. And so, if you need it, I will cover you. As long as Vanessa Creve is just, I want the Val Verde Walk of Fame goes right by Sir Mac and Cheese, and I want her body to be mashed down right on top of the Powers Booth star.
Yes.
If you can make that happen, I'll make the dreams of these little girls that you are forcing to cheer.
Yeah, sweeten the deal.
I will make their dreams come true.
Do you have any producers you're friends with?
Me?
Could you gatekeep the gatekeepers? Help out.
Well, okay.
So we can get this show on the goddamn air.
Let's see here. Scotty, will you get Jerry Bruckheimer on the line?
Ever heard of him?
Here we go. And line three, Jerry Bruckheimer, you are on the Geoff and Whisp Show, you piece of shit.
Oh, I knew it. We're talking. This is my buddy Whisp. This is my best friend Whisp. Whisp. Hey, this is Jerry Bruckheimer. I'm always cooking.
Slow down, Bruck.
I always got to keep moving. I got deals left and right. What do we got for me, Whisp?
Bruck, I've got a show. It's called Somebody's Cheering. And I just gave it a title.
I love it. You have to give Bruckheimer a title. Sure.
Otherwise, he's just not going to fucking get it. So it's called Somebody's Cheering, and it's about the Val Verde High School hard lessons. Now, you know the story about Leslie Tablets, don't you, Bruck?
Oh, of course. I almost put that into one of my movies there. I'm scraping my very light beard right now. I'm scraping my very light beard. I've been moving. I've been cutting deals. I already have a deal in the cooking for you. Let's get this moving. My lawyers are going to talk to yours. Best in the biz, Jerry Bruckheimer, out.
Click. Oh my God.
That is how the gatekeeper gets gatekeeped.
Wow.
That's it.
It's really happening.
Welcome to the local spotlight. I mean, this is what happens. We make stars in Val Verde. We're not joking around.
You really do make stars in Val Verde.
Oh my God. Well, it's going to happen. It's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
I am so excited, Crystal. Wow. I am so excited for you. When you go up and you get your Stream Time Emmy, the first thing I want to hear out of your mouth at the Stream Time Emmys is, thank you, Whisp Turlington. If I don't hear that, I will drone you all to hell.
Okay. Yeah.
Done. She takes that's it in stride. I mean, that's how you made. Take it.
I take it really seriously. I'll thank you, too. Whisp. I'll thank you, Geoff.
Do not thank Geoff.
Oh, okay. Okay.
That would be drone number 14 coming right down on your ass.
Is it okay if even though if she happens to be no longer with us, can I also be like up yours, Vanessa Creve?
I want you to make it look like you are like, and there was one woman who I couldn't have done this without, and I want you to look somber and tears and tears, and then you're like, fuck you, Vanessa Creve. And then I want to see her limp body on that, you know, that Psy thing that Psy shoots out of the stage and he's like, Gangnam Style. Have you seen the videos for that? Where they just launch Psy at least a mile up into the sky.
Yes.
And then he hits the stage and he's like, Gangnam Style.
I'm taking a month off next month to go follow Psy around. So I can't wait to see that.
You love Psy.
You're going to be a big Psy head.
Enough of Psy. I want one of those launchers there. And when you say that, I want her shot into the air where two of my drones will just rat-a-tat-tat, done.
Okay.
Just in case the running over didn't take.
Right, right.
See, I'm thinking from all angles here, that launcher that launches...
Psy just has little kids in it. That's a cheerleading move.
Wait. Those are just little kids lifting up?
Yep. They're just tossing Psy up in the air. It's called a basket toss.
Really?
Yep. Just little kids right inside that machinery. That's how that works. That's also how in the olden days when someone would get shot out of a cannon at a circus, it was just little kids doing classic cheerleading moves.
Wow.
And you got to get them small enough so that they fit inside a cannon. But then if you train them upright, they can just throw a 175-pound man. That's how much Psy weighs.
We all know it.
We all know it.
175.
Yeah, just toss him right up in the air. It's interesting. Maybe we could get together and do like a little cheerleading clinic with you guys, and I'll show you how to throw people and throw limp, lifeless bodies.
I would be into this in a heartbeat. Yeah. I have always wanted to throw Geoff as high as I can throw him and just let the drones take over from
always
there.
You know what I'm talking about. Ditto.
and then you don't have to worry about the second step, which is catching. We can just spend time focusing on the throwing. The catching's not important if the drones get
them. That's true. If the drones catch for me, I'm like, drone 48, drone 49, catch him and pull him to hell. That's what I say. Whenever I try to catch, I would say that when somebody's playing baseball with me, they're like, catch this ball. And I'm like, drone 48, get it.
I love it. You know what? I'm thinking if we can get these sponsorships, like these local businesses that sponsor you, if you're willing to sponsor, I think it'd be so cool to incorporate some of these drones into our next routine.
Oh my God. I would do that. I would do that as long as we're getting the money from Wrap it up. Oh, yeah. Wrap it up, shipping business.
Yeah,
they would totally do it.
Could be great. Could be also like a good way to cut kids that aren't, you know, that aren't.
Oh, you don't have to say anything
that aren't cutting it.
You guys step up to the plate, or you're gonna cut it.
Yeah,
as a fact.
As Drone 86 is taking their little bodies out into space, they're like, "Uh-oh, I think I was just cut from the cheer squad,"
and then they implode.
Yeah,
of course.
And then it's like more humane, honestly, because if you ever really tried to tell an 8-year-old that they're not cutting it, you know, after they've been given this amazing opportunity, and you have to look at their little face and the lip quivering. This is honestly,
I will never look at a lip quiver.
I'll never look at a lip quiver. Much easier just make it implode.
Also, my least favorite weatherman at Channel 8, whip quivers.
Oh.
Lip quivers is the worst weatherman.
It's like whip. We know it's cold. Just say it. I don't know why you're acting like this is new news.
Well, I think you've won a lot of great stuff here today, Crystal Parker. And I think we came to an agreement. I think Vanessa Creve, if you're listening, it's coming for you today. And man, we have had one hell of a segment, the local celebrity spotlight on the Geoff and Whisp show. You got to let us know how it turns out, Crystal, or we'll just read about it in the Val Verde Rag. But coming up, Skeet Ulrich in the 7 o'clock hour. Skeet's talking football.
Talking football, geez.
Why?
It's just a lecture about football?
He's telling us the history of football. Every day Skeet's on with something new, and every day we're just like, huh?
This is your thing now?
Well, at least it's not Eric Balfour. You know what I'm talking about? Oh, that's right. Oh, let's play some more classic rap.
Oh, my God.
Scotty, what is this? Is this the Doobie Brothers?
Oh, that ain't no Doobie.
That ain't no Doobies. And it's the interview. Now we're real people.
We're real human beings.
I'm not Wish Turlington. Caissie, thank you so much for being on 108.9 The Hawk.
Thank you for having me. It was so fun. I really was a cheerleader.
You were a cheerleader.
Oh.
In case you didn't know, I was trying to draw on what I knew.
No, that's the best.
I mean,
truth in comedy. Truth in comedy.
We're the first to say it.
I was actually a radio DJ, so I pull from that. But in high school, I played football for like 4 days.
Yeah.
And I quit the first day of school. I was like, I can't fucking do this anymore. So I went in to talk to Coach DeHart. And I said, Coach DeHart, I'm going to have to quit the football team. And he's like, oh, no, Slaw Dog, why? Nickname was Slaw Dog.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I'm failing math. It was the first day of school. Literally, all I got was a syllabus. And he's like, oh, hell, Slaw Dog. Why? Oh, well, you got to get that math up. Hey, you want to manage the team? The worst thing in the world. I managed the wrestling team when I was like a seventh grader. And it's the worst job ever.
They're always pitching that job. Like, do you like smells? Do you like damp things?
Hey, do you like smells and cleaning up?
Do you have a desperate need to be included and you don't mind wetness and smells?
Oh. You want to get sticky from Gatorade?
Yeah, and literally, that's all it was. And then sometimes I would be like the person doing the scoreboard, which was just this like open binder that had numbers in it. So I'd be like 1 or 2. And they'd be like, Slaw Dog, you got the wrong number over there. And I'd have to fix it. Like, oh, he didn't get that move. It was the
worst
thing in the
world. I had a harder time quitting football because I would have to tell my father my house because he was one of our high school football coaches.
Oh, my gosh.
It was a nightmare.
True story. I hope I was a cheerleader for football and basketball. Since I was like 8 years old. I really did start when I was 8, and it was all I ever wanted to do. And my high school cheerleading team was highly competitive. So we took gymnastics, we trained, did weight training, we were in many competitions. My high school has the oldest high school football rivalry in the United States.
Oh, wow.
It's over 100 years old, Fitchburg versus Leominster. And one year the game is on Thanksgiving Day. Traditionally it was on Thanksgiving Day. One year there was a blizzard on Thanksgiving Day, so the game had to be postponed, and they postponed it to a day where my cheerleading squad had a competition, but we took the competition so much more seriously than we took the like actual cheering at the games.
Oh, of course.
That we went to the competition, won it, and then like just strolled into the game like in the third quarter. And a lot of the parents were really pissed that we weren't doing our role. And I was like, we did do our role.
That's
but also
amazing.
Like real talk. Like we won some competitions, we lost some competitions. Also, one time in a competition, a girl died.
Whoa.
Was it a drone attack? It was a drone.
It wasn't a drone attack. I think she had a heart attack. God rest her soul. A young girl. But anyway, not to dwell on that, but that's like the level of competition that we were talking about.
We put our kids through a lot of physical stuff that they shouldn't be doing in sports. Yeah. In my memories.
Yeah.
And yeah, even at a young age, I was like, this seems not worth it.
It was interesting. It was like, it was a real up and coming time for cheer when I was a cheerleader. And so, and my coach, I loved her so much. She was, I adored her, but she was always trying to get us to like innovate stunts. And I just remember every year when we came back or every new competition, like a lot of times we would have to revise our routine because they had like outlawed a stunt that we had in our routine. They had like made it against the rules because they had deemed that it was too dangerous. And of course, at the time, as a kid, I was like, oh, they're messing with us and they're like wrecking our routine instead of being like, oh, they're trying to protect our lives. they're trying to make it so that only half of us fracture our necks before the 7 minutes on the floor is up. Anyway.
Oh my God.
I loved it. I'm still, my body is still fucked up to this day.
That was marching band for me. Like I pushed it in marching band. We were like, we're going to get superior at this. And we're just like all dehydrated and muscles cramping up in the stands. And
yes, I did drum and bugle corps as well. Not marching band. I was in band, but I was a cheerleader. And so that took precedence over band. So I would play in the band for anything that was still. I played the trumpet, but anything that was marching, I did cheerleading. But I was in a competitive drum and bugle corps again from like 8 to like, I don't know. I think I quit when I was like, went to middle school.
Amazing.
This might be why I didn't succeed in one of the reasons in football and lacrosse and any of the sports. And I
rock
just
and
didn't
roll.
Ever think about pushing until I started screaming in hardcore bands
in
high school in my senior year.
And you weren't willing to risk your life.
Then I would hurt myself and make myself bleed all the time. Like, yeah.
Caissie, we have a question that we typically ask, but I'm gonna change it up for you because you do so much. You've done, you know, Busy Tonight. Your podcast with Busy is so hilarious. You've done Best Week Ever, Rosie
Thank
O'Donnell
you.
Show. But the one thing I want to ask about, because we always usually ask our guests about, you know, what's your connection to classic rock? You were at Letterman for so many years as Dave's assistant. Are there any like classic rock bands that came into Letterman that you remember that were there any moments with any like Aerosmith visiting or anyone like that from that time period?
Yes. Yes. I hope. Okay. All right. A few things. One time we were joking about Greg Allman earlier.
And he's a ghost. He is a ghost that appears and he usually shoots a little pistol. I will put those in post.
In the basement of the Ed Sullivan Theater, which was kind of like the underpass of the theater where you would, that's how you got from one side of the stage to the other. And like, I was Dave's assistant, so I didn't have any business with any of the guests normally. So anything that happened would happen in passing. I was rushing from one side of the stage to the other and Greg Allman grabbed me as I was like running by and he was like, where's the bathroom? And I was like, you're standing in it. Like, he had like grabbed me from the door. I was like, if you just turn around,
yes, you found
there's a toilet right behind you.
Oh my God.
So, but I was like, you never know when people are asking where the bathroom is. Another time there was, okay, so in that same underground area was like, so a show has a green room. That's where the guests hang out. But they also had made separate from the green room a like a staff lounge, like a place for where the staff could hang out while they were, you know, watching the show on the monitor, whatever. And for whatever reason, we did have Aerosmith on and they were hanging out in the staff lounge area instead of the green room. And I was sitting there and the guys from Aerosmith were just sitting there, and one, I can't remember which one, somebody was shirtless.
Oh, and you literally just named everyone in Aerosmith except for the
drummer. Like he hadn't gotten around to putting his shirt on. I don't know where his shirt was. I can't remember which one it was.
Steven Tyler or Joe
it
Perry.
Wasn't Steven. Yes.
Joe Perry.
Yes. It was Joe Perry.
Was he ripped? Was he like muscles?
Yeah, he looked great. Yeah, but the thing is, like, Dave was also at that moment, like, passing by, like, he came and he saw, and then he was like, Caissie, get over here, like, come with me. And I was like, oh, okay. And so I caught up with him, and he was like, why is Aerosmith, like, sitting down there in this staff lounge, and why does that man not have a shirt on? And I was like, I don't know. Like, why would I know any of this? I don't know. They just came down there, and I didn't ask where his shirt was. And he was like, I'm telling you right now, when they're performing, if Joe Perry comes up and puts his foot on the home base and plays his guitar to me, like serenades me with his guitar, I'm going to die of embarrassment. I'm just telling you right now. And I was like, ha ha ha.
Yeah.
But legitimately, when the show was happening, one of Dave's assistants would always be on the side of the stage. And I loved, you know, and I'm from Massachusetts, so I was like, I'm going to be out there for Aerosmith. Mm-hmm. And sure enough, Joe Perry, like, rocked up to the home base where Dave was sitting at his desk and put his foot up there. And Dave, like, literally looked at me like they look at the camera in the office. I was dying of laughter. It was so funny. And I just was like, that's a guy that knows his job so well that he just could feel it. He could feel it from those basement vibes.
Yep.
This motherfucker is going to come put his foot on home base and, like, play guitar to me. And I'm going to have to act like I love it. He did love it. Dave loved the band. That's the thing.
Yeah.
But it's just that he had a high level of secondhand embarrassment. And for, like, a guy on TV, I don't think he actually loved attention. So, you know, anyone, it's like when people sing happy birthday to you, like, what are you supposed to do?
Oh, I love it. I suck it all in. I'm just like, more.
Give me more.
It's like life force. It's like life force.
I just love that he 100% called it. And he was like, see, here he is, foot on home base.
Caissie, thank you so much for being here with us. Any plugs? I'm sure you want to plug the cast.
Yeah, I mean, listen to the podcast that I co-host and produce. It's called Busy Phillips Is Doing Her Best. My co-host is obviously the actor and performer and love bug, Busy Phillips. She's my friend. And we have other stuff coming up that I don't think we can announce yet, but it might be happening by the time this comes out. So maybe just, like, check my Instagram or something and I'll be telling you.
Just send it over to us and we can put it in the show notes too. Thank you so much. We'd love to have you back. This was so much fun.
I love you guys so much, and I love the show, and I'm so honored that you had my friend Crystal Parker on the Hawk.
Oh, Crystal's the best. We got to find out about the premeditated murder. We got to see if it worked. Hands down, the greatest Aerosmith story I have ever heard. And I just want to pop in here. Hello, everyone. This is Jason Gore from 108.9 The Hawk. And I want to tell you that the thing that Caissie could not announce in this episode when we recorded it has been announced. It is a brand new late night show on QVC Plus, Busy This Week. And that premieres on May 8th with Caissie and Busy. Busy This Week, a weekly late night talk show on QVC Plus, starts on May 8th, so make sure you check that out. Also, if you want to support the show, guys, here's what you do. You go to the Patreon, patreon.com/1089thehawk. You get episodes a week early, bonus episodes, Hawk Rock Talk, Talk to the Hawk, Art Spart Monster Hunter, Album Poll, so many different shows that you get. At the Just Like Paradise tier, you get video versions of the shows and other fun videos. If you love the podcast, if you love The Hawk, please help us out at patreon.com/1089thehawk. And also, wherever you listen to this podcast, let's say you're listening on Apple Podcasts, pop on there, give us a 5-star review. It does help out the show. And most importantly, tell your friends. If you like this and you have friends that are like you, chances are good they're going to like 108.9 The Hawk. So spread the word. We will be back next week with a return of DC Pierson. That's coming up on 108.9 The Hawk.